Hey guys, Steph here. I am the former secret slob, and this year I am practicing low stress Christmas and general holiday prep. So I am focusing on three things this holiday season. Number one, making sure my house doesn't get out of control messy, because that's always a problem for me. Number two, getting all of my Christmas stuff done without stressing about it. And number three, a little bit of self-care and pampering. So how are you doing with the evening routine? I am on week two or three without a dishwasher now, and I'm definitely struggling a little bit with my dishes, but I'm really trying to get them done at night. My husband helps, and he even shines the sink now, which is really nice. The hotspot is something I just have to keep on top of, because with things coming in and out of the house so much this time of year, it is crazy. So I'm trying really hard to take care of that every single night. And then putting my laundry away, another one that I'm like always struggling with, but I'm working really hard to just get those little loads of laundry done every single day and put them away. So that is going well. I'm keeping up my morning routine, and my house is looking pretty good, and I'm feeling a little bit less stressed than I was a couple weeks ago. So that is awesome. So holiday stuff, I am so pleased to say that I have set a all-time brand new record for myself. I am done my Christmas shopping, and it is December 3rd. So I'm so proud of myself. I set out to get stuff done early this year. I don't want to be rushing around. I don't want to feel stressed. I don't want to be at the mall when things are all picked over and I don't get any selection. And so I'm finished my holiday shopping. I just worked on it this whole week and got it done. And on to self-care. Self-care this week, our challenge was to sit and read a book with a cup of hot chocolate or tea or hot coffee and just get a little bit cozy and enjoy yourself. So I've been doing that. I've read two books this week. I'll link to them below. And they're both pretty good and just super light. I'm trying not to read anything too heavy over the holiday season, just nice and light stuff. And one was for my book club, and I'm finished early, so that'll be lots of fun to get together with the girls in a couple weeks and discuss the book. So let's go back to the shopping part and talk a little bit about gifts, because I know for me, gift buying can sometimes be super stressful. So I just wanted to quickly go over my five categories of gifts that I try to stick to when I'm buying gifts for people at Christmas time that I find I have some success with. I don't like buying stuff just for the sake of buying stuff, and I hate buying stuff that I know people are never going to use. So I'm gonna show you really quick what I bought for some people in my family. And if you are in my family, just stop watching now, Mom. Okay, so my number one category of things to buy for people is experiences. I'm sure you've been hearing this a lot lately, especially because minimalism is kind of on the rise and people don't want a lot of extra stuff in their house always. So experiences. This can be something that you do together, like a concert or a play, or maybe you go out and do like an adventure thing, or it could just be something that you know the person enjoys doing. So maybe you buy them passes to go to the movies. Maybe they're a movie buff. One place where I have replaced gifts with experiences in my life is my mother-in-law and my two sister-in-laws and me. A few years ago, decided to stop buying gifts for each other, and we instead go and get pedicures close to Christmas, and then we go out for lunch. And it is just the most lovely day, and we all just pay for ourselves, since we were gonna buy gifts for each other anyways. We just pay for ourselves, and that is our new little Christmas tradition. I think we've done it about 4 years in a row now, and I really look forward to it every year. And this year, we're doing it super close to Christmas, because they're all going to Hawaii right after New Year's, which I'm not going because I'll be a million weeks pregnant, but they'll have nice toes for Hawaii and I'll have nice toes for Christmas. So that is our experience that we do instead of gifts, and I love it. My number two best gift to give people is gift cards. So these are the gift cards I got for the preschool teachers at my daughter's school, and they're coffee cards. So gift cards can be kind of funny too. You don't wanna just buy a gift card willy-nilly that maybe you don't even know the person likes that store, or I mean, I've even gotten gift cards for stores that aren't even here in my town and I have to travel out of town and remember to use them. Don't do that. I have seen the teachers at our preschool drinking coffee from this coffee shop so many times that I know they will use these. So gift cards can be a really thoughtful gift, but do try to put a little bit of thought into where you're purchasing them for. Really try to hone in on something that you know that they'll use and not feel obligated to use, and it's not gonna waste away in a drawer somewhere. We've all had gift cards that we just didn't use because they just weren't for stuff we wanted. Number three, so, and this is probably my favorite one. It is consumables. So this is chocolate. It's for my mom. I buy this for her every year. It's like a toffee thing, She loves it. And it's a super easy gift to buy because I know I'm not contributing to stuff in her house. It's a special treat. I know she looks forward to it. And it's an easy gift to grab. So consumables, you know people are gonna eat them and it's gonna get used up and it's not gonna contribute to clutter in their life. So I love consumables. Other good ones include really nice bath stuff if you know they'll use it, candles, things like that. Stuff that people can use and then it will be gone from their life and they won't feel compelled to keep forever and ever. Okay, number four, stuff they need. This one I'm specifically talking about my kids because I bought my kids pajamas for Christmas. How cute. And socks. And let's be honest, I was gonna buy them new socks and new pajamas anyways. They need them. But it's always fun to get fresh socks and fresh jammies. So just link them up with a gift. My friend said that's what she fills her kids' stockings with every year. New underwear, new socks. And it's always so nice to get all that fresh stuff, even though you were probably gonna buy it for them anyways. So stuff they need. Category number five, and this is a big one and it takes a little bit of planning, but stuff they want. So I really try, and with my husband especially, because he's so hard to buy for, usually I just give him chocolate, but I just try to listen in the months leading up to Christmas for things that he maybe wants or things he wishes he had. So this year I heard him talking about wanting a new, what is this? Screwdriver set with all the different bits because his bits were all wearing out. And I noticed because I was using one, I was like, this isn't working. He said, yeah, I need a new set of bits. Perfect. So the minute he said that, I went and wrote it down so that I would remember for Christmas time that that might be something that he wants. So this one does take a bit of planning, but if you're smart, you'll listen for when your friends say things like, oh, I love everything from that store. Or, oh, I really just wish I had a nice this, or I would buy this for myself, but I feel like it's a luxury. So over the year, and I keep a little list in my phone, just listen to what the people around you are saying, what they're talking about, what they're excited about, and then you've got a sure thing come Christmas. It's not really fun, like I say, to have to feel obligated or forced to buy something you have no idea they'll like. I've done that for my husband before. We have stuff wasting away in drawers that he's not gonna use. It's not stuff he ever wanted in the first place. So stuff they want. Takes a little bit of planning, but just keep your ear open. Everybody kind of will mention something here and there. So those are my five categories of gifts that I use to shop for Christmas gifts for people. If you have other categories or other really awesome, sure thing, never fail gift ideas, share them in the comments below. I love reading about everyone's Christmas traditions and gift traditions, and maybe you're giving up gifts all together this year. So I'm so proud of myself for getting my gift shopping done. I've got my maternity dress for the Christmas party and I've been taking care of myself and I'm already in the Christmas spirit. We got our tree this weekend and I'm not feeling so stressed about it at all. Did you get your shopping done this week? Are you taking care of yourself? I want to hear about it. Let me know in the comments and I will talk to you very soon. Bye.